Okay, here is the next video lecture here on learning and behavior theories. We next move to instrumental or operant conditioning. So we're moving away from classical conditioning, which we were going to spend the most time on, and now we're moving into learning that occurs not instinctively necessarily, but through a series of reinforcements and punishments. This is a good definition to have. We've already talked a little bit about positive and negative reinforcement, I realize, and we're going to revisit that. John Watson was a famous psychologist, and he had this quote. He's basically saying, give me whoever you want, and if I put them in the right environment, I can make them turn out to be pretty much whatever I want them to be, just by manipulating the environment. Talk about tie in with personality and mental illness and mental wellness. You can actually instrumentally condition someone to have a personality disorder, perhaps, or not to have one. So, I mean, we can talk about that. His famous quote, you don't have to know this, but he's basically saying what I just said to you. Now, if you remember from your intro classes and from our brief discussions already in this class, reinforcement involves increasing the chances that a specific behavior will be repeated in the future. That's what reinforcement is. Reinforcement is increasing the chances or likelihood that a behavior will happen again. Positive reinforcement, think of positive not in terms of good or bad here. Think of positive in terms of giving or administering something. Okay? Positive reinforcement means you're going to give something good or pleasurable, again, to increase the chances that something will happen in the future. So let's start with positive reinforcement. So if I want to increase the chances that my daughter will clean her room, okay, I can give her something to help increase those chances. What might I give her? Well, it has to be something that she likes. I know that she likes money. So what I might say is, all right, Madison, I'll give you $10 a week if you keep your room clean. And that might be enough to positively reinforce that behavior. As adults, you're positively reinforced for working. You're given a paycheck. If you stop getting that paycheck, it's going to probably decrease the chances that you're going to go back to your job because nobody works for free. Okay. Now, negative, think of negative in terms of taking away. Don't think of it in terms of being, again, good or bad. Negative reinforcement means you're going to take away something aversive or bad, again, with the same goal of increasing the chances that a behavior will be repeated. Let's use cleaning your room as the same example here. What I might say to my daughter is, okay, if you will keep your room clean, then I will take away your other chores, like taking out the trash, things that I know you don't like to do. An example for class, if I want to reinforce class attendance, I want to increase the chances that everybody will come to class in the future, I could take away something that you don't like, such as an exam. I might say, and I'm not saying this by the way, but hypothetically, I might say, all right, class, if we have perfect attendance for the next 3 weeks, then no one has to take the third exam. Everybody would just be exempt from that, and that could work. So those are a couple of examples of negative reinforcement. Money is probably one of the best reinforcers that we have. Now, punishment, on the other hand, we're going to go the opposite. Whereas reinforcement is increasing, punishment is decreasing the chances that a specific behavior will happen again. I'm going to adjust my camera because I feel like I'm not getting everything here. Oh, there we go. Okay. Now, positive and negative mean exactly the same things with punishment as they do with reinforcement. Okay. Punishment simply means that we're going to remove or take something away to decrease the behavior. Okay. Positive simply means that we're going to be giving or administering something to decrease the behavior. Negative means that we're going to be taking away something to decrease the chances of a behavior. So positive means you're giving, negative means you're taking away again. So if I want to decrease the chances that my young daughter will curse in church, that's really what she did to me one Sunday, and that was a traumatic experience. When a child drops an F-bomb in a quiet church sanctuary for everybody to hear, everybody looks at dad like he's the one that taught her. But, you know, we won't go there. I could positively punish her for that behavior. I could give her something she doesn't like to decrease the chances that she will do that again. What might those things be? I could give her a spanking. I could give her a scolding. I could give her extra chores to do. But whatever it is I'm giving her has to be unpleasant, something that she doesn't like. Negative punishment means we're taking something positive away. Grounding is the best example of a negative punishment. My parents spanked me regularly, and with good reason probably, when I was a juvenile delinquent in my younger days. And I was always fine with it because a spanking would last a couple minutes, it would hurt for a minute, and then you would be fine. I could go on doing whatever it is I wanted to do. Except one day I came home from school and my parents said to me, "We're not going to spank you anymore for being bad." I was ready to have a party. I'm like, "Yeah, all right." Instead, what they said was, "You know, we're going to ground you. We're going to take away stuff that you like and make you not be able to do it for like a week or 2 weeks." And I was like, whoa, wait a minute now. What happened to the spanking? That was a lot better. They would take away from me my outside time. Playing outside with friends was a big deal after school. When you were young, in my generation, they would take it away. They would ground me. I wasn't allowed to go outside and play. Now parents will take away their children's cell phones or their laptops. These are examples of negative punishment with the goal of decreasing that negative behavior. So, let's go ahead and call that the end of this part. Thanks.